Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Savarna. I'm a front-end developer, and in this tutorial we're going to see how to create the loading animation in HTML and CSS. These are the three easy and quick loading animation that you can create in no time. The first one is a circle animation, the second one is a three-dot animation, and the third one is a grid animation. Let's see how to create them. Here I use brackets as a code editor and the live preview option right here to see the output as we code. I open up the index.html and I'm going to start with the usual HTML head and body tags. I'm going to give a link to the style sheet. Now let's give it a background color. Alright, the first animation that we're going to see is a circular loading animation. So let's go ahead and create a div container for that with a class called circle. Now let's style them. Let's give it a margin, width and height. The auto in the margin is going to center them horizontally and the top and bottom is going to be 70 pixels wide. Let's give this a border with a color that is almost transparent. Now let's give the border radius as 50% to make it circular. And let's give the border top color as white. Okay, now all we have to do is to spin them, rotate them at 360 degrees. To do this, we'll use add keyframe followed by the animation name. And using the transform property, we will rotate it at 360 degrees at 100%. Now let's add this animation to our circle using animation attribute. The animation name, the time, and infinite, so it would keep spinning. If you notice, the speed is not same from the starting to end. For this, we will specify the animation timing function as linear. Alright, we have created the circle loading animation. Now let's move on to the three-dot loading animation. To create this, I'm going to give a div container and a separate div container for each dots. Everyone will have a common class dot and a separate class dot 1, dot 2 and dot 3 to identify them individually. First, let's give the basic width and margin for the complete container. And specify width and height for each dots. I will give display as inline block. And for now, let's give background color as white so it will be visible. By default, the display is block for every div container. So we'll change it to inline block so that it would appear next to each other. Now we'll give border radius as 50% to make it circular. Alright, now I'll remove the background color and give separate background color for each dots using the separate class names. Alright, there's the three dots. As you can see in this animation, the dots kind of jump up and down one after the other. So let's define the animation using add keyframes followed by the animation name jump up. And we will move it along the y-axis using transform property. Okay, now let's specify the animation. First the animation name, the time it takes, and I'm going to give a delay of 0.1 second followed by the timing function and infinite. For the second dot, I'm going to give 0.2 seconds as the animation delay, and for dot 3, it is going to be 0.3 seconds. So they will jump up one after the other and not at the same time. Alright, there it is. Now for the last one, grid block loading animation. Let's go back to index.html and similar to the previous one, we are going to give a div class container and a separate class for each block. Now let's give the width and height for each box. And I'm going to give the background color that is lighter than the body background color. Again, we'll specify the display as inline block. If you notice, the container is of width 40 pixel and each block is of width 15 pixel. So the third block would automatically come down. Okay, now for the animation. This is very simple. We just have to toggle the opacity on and off. So let's mention that. And specify the animation to our box. I'm going to mention it as Esyn for a slow start. Now all the boxes are toggling opacity on and off. Now let's specify the direction as alternator, so each time it alternates the direction from forward to backward and vice versa. Also, let's mention the animation delay for box 2 and box 3 so we would get the desired effect. Alright, so there it is, the three types of loading animation that you can create in CSS. Hope you liked it. Share your feedbacks in the comments down below, and thanks for watching.